In the last video, we talked about how to combine functions to get something that is continuous. Now I want to talk about the ways in which a function can fail to be continuous. There are three main types of discontinuities that can occur for a function. The first one is where you have a limit from the left, and it's a perfectly good finite number, and a limit from the right, and it's a perfectly good finite number, and they don't agree. This is called a jump discontinuity, because you're just jumping from this height to this height. And it doesn't matter what the actual value is. If the value is that, you're still jumping. If the value is up here, you're still jumping. If the value is here, you're still jumping. If the value is here, you're still jumping. No matter what, so you don't actually care what the value of f of a is for these purposes. It may not even exist. If the limit from the left and the limit from the right are both finite numbers that are different from each other, then you have yourself a jump discontinuity. Now, the next kind of discontinuity is shown by the function f of x equals 1 over x squared as we approach x equals 0. Both functions are going to infinity. Now, it happens that 1 over 0 squared doesn't exist, but we could define a function to be this when x is not 0, and maybe 3 if x equals 0. But that wouldn't fix our problem, because this point down here can't connect this and this. This is going to infinity, this is going to infinity, and infinity is not a number. You can't say f of 0 is infinity. That doesn't make sense. No matter what number you pick to be f of 0, they don't match up. So if one side goes to infinity, or the other side goes to infinity, it's an infinite discontinuity. Now, often this happens with one side going up and the other side going down, but it doesn't matter. If at least one side is going either to infinity or to minus infinity, we call this an infinite discontinuity, and it's sometimes called an asymptotic discontinuity because the vertical axis, the vertical line, you have a vertical asymptote. And that's what's happening here. The third important kind of discontinuity is where the two limits are the same. Like if you look at the function x squared minus x over x minus 1, it doesn't make sense that x equals 1 because that's dividing by 0. But everywhere else, this is equal to x. So we get this nice line going through this spot. Only the value of the function there isn't 1. If the value may not exist, or maybe the value is something that's wrong. Now we call this a removable discontinuity because by changing the function ever so slightly, by just specifying the value at this one point, we can fill in the dot, ignore these dots, and then we have a nice continuous function. That's called a removable discontinuity. Finally, I should point out that there are other kinds of discontinuity out there. If you look at the function f of x equals sine of 1 over x, then you look at what's happening as x approaches 0 from either side. The function isn't blowing up, but it doesn't have a limit either. But those things are much, much rarer. In general, the kind of discontinuities you're going to see over and over and over again is you're going to see jumps, you're going to see things going to infinity, so these are infinite discontinuities, and you're going to see holes in the graph. This hole we just filled in, but before we filled it in, it was a removable discontinuity.